look who I found today. It's Will.
Baby, you're short. I gotta go. Show them how low I'm squatting.
Hey guys, this is One in a Million. Today we are here at KCON day 2, and we're gonna check out the convention. We're gonna see if we can check out some panels, though it's like really full, I'm not gonna lie. It took 2 hours to get in here, and last time I was here, it took me 30 minutes, and today we were literally lined by the street and circling the entire Staples Center and LA Convention Center twice. It was crazy. I've never seen it this crazy before. But I'm very excited. I'm excited to get some freebies. I'm excited to see some K-pop idols. Excited to maybe buy some skincare or makeup. So if you guys are ready, let's KCON!
First, I had to check out some of the booths in the lifestyle section and search for some free goodies. Many of them had you do missions or play games in order to win freebies that ranged all the way from food to skincare to cute merch. And I do have to say, the most unexpected but pleasant surprise was the Korea Agro-Fisheries and Food Trade Corporation hosting the K-Food 101 booth. They even had red ginseng Korean extract to buy, which brought me back to that one time I worked on the camera department for one of their commercials. The K-Food booth had so many amazing freebies and samples, I just had to do a special mukbang for you.
All right guys, it's time for a mukbang. We're gonna try all the goodies that I just grabbed from the Korea Agro-Fisheries and Food Trade Corporation, also listed as the K-Food 101 booth. They gave me a lot of stuff. Honestly, they were so warm and kind. They saw me filming and they were like, here, try this, try this, try this. Just make sure to post a video and tag us. So that was really nice because I was already gonna make a video, and if they gave me food, I already was gonna react to it. So let's go ahead and get started. First of all, they gave me this milky soup, I guess in Korean. Milky soup, peach flavor. And here is a sample for it. So even though it's like, you think milk, it actually doesn't taste like milk at all. It looks kind of like darker, like white, like thick consistency, just because it's like not like water where it's see-through. There clearly is color to it, but it tastes just like peach juice. So very nice, refreshing. I can imagine if you like pop these in the fridge, drink them on a hot day, or like drink them with some ice, it'll be nice and refreshing, especially for the summer. Next, they gave me this brain drink. You can put it either in ice water or in milk. You mix it and it kind of, first of all, it looks like this. So this one even more so has a milk consistency. It looks just like milk if we compare it with the milkiest. This one's more watery, this one's the milkiest, and this one's the grain drink. And this one does have more of a milk consistency. This one just looks thick, but it's more liquidy. This one's more thick. Let's try it. So this one does feel more like milk, but it kind of reminds me of like rice milk. It actually tastes exactly what I remember rice milk to taste like. So it's actually really good. I'm looking forward to trying more of these actually on the regular, because I'm a big nut milk fan, be it almond milk or oat milk, because of my dairy allergy. So I'm unfortunately not able to drink milk, cow milk like a lot of people. But yeah, this is very tasty and a great alternative. All right, let's move on. So they also gave me this crispy squid snack. And here it is with like another snack that they gave me. Let's try it. This one's the crispy squid snack. It's actually kind of crunchy, but then once you get into the squid, it's chewy like a squid. And it tastes like squid. It's like deep fried squid almost. like deep fried squid turned into chips. Kind of reminds me, if you're a fan of shrimp chips, which I was obsessed with shrimp chips when I was in college, definitely recommend. I think you guys will like that. And then this one, I have no idea what this one is, but it was right next to the shrimp chips.
It looks like seaweed.
Yeah, it looks like deep fried, almost like barbecue-y seaweed. This is pretty good. This one's crunchier too. Okay, I like that. Next, we're gonna try a surprise. Oh, this is like rice porridge. All right, let's try that with the spoon they gave us. They did not give me a napkin, so that's gonna be a little tough finding a napkin somewhere here. All right, let's try this. It's pretty good. It's a little cold though. I feel like this would have been better like warm. But I really like the consistency. I'm a big fan of rice porridge. This is my lunch, you guys. You know how it is at KCON. They always give you so much food and snacks that you don't really need to buy lunch.
Ooh, they gave me some tteokbokki. Look at that.
So the cookie is spicy rice cake, but let's hope it's not too spicy. They gave me this like two-pronged toothpick fork to stab it with. Let's see, hopefully it's not too spicy. Mm. Oh, it's tasty. It even has a little bit of oldang or fish cake, which is popular to add in the cookie. Pretty good, pretty good. Not too spicy, very nice and chewy. This is exciting. This is like legit Korean food that they prepared for everyone. It's actually really, really nice. So here we're gonna try some tteok that looks a lot like songpyeon for chuseok, but it's not half moon shaped, so it might not be. Oh, it's stuck. Okay, so this one is supposed to be more of like a dessert. So I'm curious what it has inside, but it's super squishy already. Wow. Very, very glutinous and delicious. I can't wait. Okay, let's see. What is this? I don't know what's inside there, but it's kind of liquidy and sweet. Tteokbokki is a type of tteok that's like for, you know, meals. And then this kind of tteok is like for dessert. It's like brown sugar, and I can't pinpoint what else it is. It's like liquidy brown sugar. It's really good. They also gave me this jar of November citron tea, which almost looks like honey. So I'm excited to try that. It's preserved citron 65% and honey 2%. So you can drink this in tea, but I can imagine you could also like spread this on toast. Like American style, you know. And then they also gave me this. I don't know what this is. It's like something about a sticker. I'm afraid to open it. It looks like there's more samples for the multi-grain, black grain, and super grain drinks. So I'm excited to try that at home because I'm gonna need to mix it with water and I don't have water here with me. So at the K-Food 101 booth, I went through the different areas to get stamps to fill out the certificate, and that's how they slowly gave me all these samples. And then at the end, once you complete all four of these stamps, they gave me this. So it's a mini mug cup two-piece set, and I'm so excited to see what this is because it's like based on their mascot. It's gonna be hard with my nails, guys, like not even. I need to use tools with these nails to open things up. Ooh, okay, unboxing time. Oh my gosh, they're so cute. I don't want them to fall out. Look at this. Aren't they the cutest? They're tiny little mugs.
Look, they're so tiny. This is like super dainty and cute.
All right, guys, I'm gonna finish all of this and then we're gonna go back to see some more stuff, okay? See you See you soon.
As we continue on adventuring through the con, it's good to mention other notable booths, which included the CJ Live Studio that I caught in the middle of interviewing popular TikToker Loga GM, Skin1004, which had an aesthetic backdrop with an underwater projection that made for great pictures and videos. They were also generous enough to present me with a bag of skincare goodies for the road. Rakuten Vicky was another great spot where you could pick from three prizes for a special surprise inside a boba cup, and I gotta say I got lucky with mine. This booth was based on the popular reality TV show Ginny's Kitchen, which featured popular celebrities like actor Lee Seo-jin from Grandpa Over Flowers, global superstar V from BTS, who also previously acted in the hit drama Hwarang, popular Korean actor Park Seo-joon, who was in Parasite and will be appearing in the new Marvel sequel to Captain Marvel, The Marvels, Choi Woo-shik, fellow Parasite co-star, and actress Jung Yoo-mi from Train to Busan. This booth had games for you to play to win a variety of different prizes. But let's talk about running into K-pop idols for a second. I saw not just Xikers up close and personal walk on by. Also saw Just Be by the McDonald's booth and Kevin Woo presenting Very Very on stage. I'd also like to give an honorable mention to ATEEZ at the KQ Entertainment stage/booth, but I personally don't count it because my camera only saw them through other people's phones. Talking about meeting idols, I had an extra special meetup with my favorite G group participant from Boys Planet.
Look who I found today, it's Will.
Baby, you're short. I gotta go. Show them how low I'm squatting. On my fucking knee.
Now, real height.
This is like Dexter's Lab where the parents, or no, Powerpuff Girls. Who was it where the tall people?
The Powerpuff Girls. The Powerpuff Girls are tiny and Professor, what was his name? Professor
Something X.
Professor X?
Yeah.
Professor X? That seems like it's from something else.
Maybe that's another video I was watching.
Professor, just Professor. They call them Professor.
Professor?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm gonna look it up.
Or,
Professor Utonium? Was that right? Professor Utonium?
Something.
Let me check.
We're matching.
We're matching. Like, show the nails, babe. You probably already did.
They match your jewel.
Period.
Will, Sydney, and I roamed around and decided to visit the K-Conners Choice section, which was dedicated to our newest kids on the block, ZEROBASEONE. But not gonna lie, I was disappointed that they didn't have any goodies to give out, especially since Kepler had freebies at theirs last year. After we were done with the convention, we popped by the K-pop village, which was pretty much closing down by the time we got there, but we got to see the Ferris wheel in action, as well as some of contestant Will Williams' dance moves.
So I came back to my car to drop my things off, and now it's time to go to the concert.
The lines to get into the concert were ironically not as long as the lines to get into the convention this morning. So we were able to enjoy some time posing for pictures before the main event. And without further ado, let's KCON.
Give it up for warm welcome for me! McDonald's, Asiana Airlines, Olive Young, Korea Cultural Heritage Foundation, Skin 1004, Samdasu, Talcom Soft, Rakuten Vicky, Poco Market, Muse Live, Incheon Airport, Yususa, Into You, Eyes Press, and University of Utah, Tourneju. All right, K-Conners, I will not take up any more of your time. I'm Alex Reed. It has been a pleasure being your host tonight. So let's get one more cheer before we get started. When I say let, you say K-Con. Let! K-Con! Let! K-Con!
Thank you. big concert like this, and we are grateful and happy to meet for K-pop fans from all over the world.
선배 아티스트들이 오랜 시간 땀과 열정으로 만들어주신 소중한 노래인 만큼 저희도 책임감을 갖고 글로벌 K-pop 팬들의 기대에 부응할 수 있는 멋진 음악과 무대를 선보여야겠다는 다짐이 생기는데요.
you wherever and whenever. Please don't forget that. And come find us anytime. Now, let's wrap up KCON!
That is the end for KCON Day 2, both the convention as well as the concert. I hope you guys really enjoyed this video, and if you did, please let me know in the comments down below which was your favorite part, and make sure to share it with your K-pop loving friends. I will see you guys in the next video, which is also the very start of my 15-part vlog series in Korea, so I hope you guys look forward to that. See you guys, bye!